Hi everyone, this is Real World Audio, and today we are continuing our balanced versus unbalanced gear series. And today I'm talking about speaker cables and amplifiers, namely tube amplifiers. And here we go. So if you want balanced cables that will give you a balance between resolution, tonality, and other pairs, then Kimber and Harmonic Technologies are examples that I'm familiar with that I can recommend. So if you use these, then it will help your system to go towards a balanced route. An example for unbalanced cables is MIT cables, which sacrifice tonality for higher resolution, and also this is one thing why there is so much disagreements on cables, because it is not just that one cable is better than the other or not, but they do different things to the overall sound. And for example, like these brands, the cables they make, they keep your system more balanced, but it also means that they do not give you such high resolution as MIT. So MIT cables, and not just speaker cables, but their power cords, interconnects, etc., they will all change your sound towards this more mechanically perfect sound, which sounds like more processed, but it has it seems to have like higher detail level, faster speed, but it is a little bit unnatural. It goes really well together with certain audio brands, but I don't really want to go into that. Look for Real Hi-Fi Help. He has a lot of experience and a lot of advice on how to use MIT cables. He can give you a lot of pointers on that. So today we are continuing on to tube amplifiers. And for balanced amplifiers, Quicksilver Audio is an excellent example. So all of their amps have a really nice balance in their audio pairs, in their audio qualities, and you can use them as a nice anchor in your system, so a nice central component to use your other to select your source, your loudspeaker, to mate it with that. So in our previous episode, I mentioned like Wonderstein speakers and Ryan speakers. They will work absolutely wonderfully with the Quicksilver amps, but also with the Conrad Johnson amps. So CJ Conrad Johnson is another example for balanced gear. They balanced out their amplifiers pretty well. And partially, I think that's one of the reasons why Conrad Johnson is the leader U.S. High-end company, or has been the leading U.S. high-end company, has been recognized as I would say a staple manufacturer of amplifiers. And it's really a very good baseline to compare other amplifiers against. And I would also add rebuilt vintage amplifiers to the balanced example, because the older amplifiers, I mean like 70s, 80s, and going back even to the 60s, 50s, 40s, when they were built, the engineers use their ears to a much greater degree than today's engineers are doing it. And also at that time, people were much less exposed to recorded music, much less exposed to processed music. Music was much more analog, and the more you go back in time for your vintage gear, the better the tonality is, or the better the potential for good tonality is. And also it means that in every single case you need to rebuild that amplifier, because it needs new capacitors, new solder joints, wires, etc., to really bring it up to speed. If you don't do that, and you maybe just do a restoration with someone and then restore like the exact same parts it used to have, then you will have a sound which is much better than without restoration, but you will be missing out tremendously on the potential of these vintage amplifiers. You will miss out about 95% of their resolution capability. You will miss out completely on their low-level resolution capacity. You will miss out a lot on the frequency extensions and microdynamics. It will be just a fraction of what you could get. And also for unbalanced gear, I would, for tube amplifiers, I would list vintage amplifiers, all of them without rebuilding, or you just rebuild them with their respective parts that they were originally made with. They have excellent tonality, but resolution and everything else that I just mentioned before will be really just a shadow compared to what the average of modern gear can do. And for other unbalanced gear examples, I would maybe add BAT, Balanced Audio Technologies, and tube amplifiers, which really enforce resolution versus tone, and frequency extensions against mid-range. But the skewing that they do is not as big as any other components. So I would say that even though like tube amps, they really are responsible for a lot of the sound, but if they are properly done, then they do relatively little in the skewing of these audio twin pairs. So thank you for tuning in. Please like, subscribe, tell your friends, and we will continue next time with solid state amplifiers. Bye bye.